Granting Hope, Stories of Pelotonia-funded research at the Ohio State University Comprehensive Cancer Center, James Cancer Hospital, and Solove Research Institute. Endometrial cancer, which begins in the lining of a woman's uterus, is the fourth most frequently diagnosed cancer among women, and the number one type of cancer affecting the female reproductive system. Around the world, endometrial cancer diagnoses are increasing, with the number of cases going up over the last 30 years. Dr. Theodore Brasky, an epidemiologist and member of the Cancer Control Program at the James at Ohio State, believes endometrial cancer does not get the attention it deserves.
It's an understudied disease. It's underfunded, understudied, especially when you compare endometrial cancer and the amount of funding that goes towards it at the National Institutes of Health compared to, say, breast cancer, colon cancer, and lung cancer, the next top diseases, the next top cancers in Americans.
Dr. Brasky, whose work focuses on the link between inflammation and cancer, is a member of a research team hoping to find ways to reduce the incidence of endometrial cancer. The project is funded by a Pelotonia Idea grant.
I think the work really started with some of my work as an epidemiologist examining different risk factors for endometrial cancer. We've noted that certain diets, particularly those high in long-chain omega-3 fatty acids, are associated with a reduced risk of endometrial cancer, at least in some women.
Another member of the research team, Dr. Kateshi Kurita, believes the increase in endometrial cancer cases indicates a connection between the disease and lifestyle habits.
Endometrial cancer is one of a few cancers that both the incidence and the mortality are increasing in developed countries, including the United States. And that suggests that there must be a lifestyle factor contribute to this cancer, the progression, the high incidence and mortality of this cancer.
One of the things the researchers hope to determine is whether by consuming foods high in long-chain omega-3 fatty acids, women can lower their risk of developing endometrial cancer.
We think that inflammation is important in endometrial cancer initiation and progression. And diets high in long-chain omega-3 fatty acids, these are fish oil-based, so they're marine fatty acids. These fatty acids have been shown in a variety of trials to have anti-inflammatory properties.
Dr. Kurita's contribution to the project will be developing a biological model to test the premise that by reducing inflammation, diets rich in omega-3 fatty acids can lead to a decrease in endometrial cancer cases. He is glad to be part of the team because of the collaborative nature of the project.
Our group always focuses on the signal transduction, genetic mutations, but that is not all about cancer. Cancer is more systemic and more complex disease. It involves the entire system, like immune system, microenvironment, hormones, everything. And to understand these things, I need also the input from the physicians, epidemiologists. So I'm very excited about this project.
Doctors Brasky and Kurita stress the importance of the Pelotonia Idea Grant in furthering their research by making their collaboration possible.
This sort of collaboration wouldn't necessarily fly in other grant mechanisms. You need to show that we can work together first, we can show that our idea is successful, and then we move forward.
Pelotonia and the James at Ohio State, granting hope to cancer patients and the people working for a cancer-free world.